Hello, my dear students. I hope you all are well and fine. So once again, welcome back to your geography class. In this class, I am going to discuss one of the important topic of your syllabus, that is denudation process. So in the last class, I have discussed about the weathering. So before starting this chapter, let's recall this weathering chapter once in a very short time. Now, what is weathering? Weathering means wearing down of rocks, but without its removal. Without its removal means when the rock material is wearing out from a particular place, at that time they will not be transported on a like from a particular place to another place. So transportation or removal will not take place. Now denudation means here the removal of rock will definitely take place. Now what is that? Suppose I'm just giving you first the general definition or the general concept of denudation. Previously the landform was like this, but after this denudation process means it is a continuous process. The landform will be eroded away and the structure of the landform will be like this. So here, see, previously it was like this, now it has lowered down. Okay, so this is called denudation, when a particular landform will be wearing down by several processes. Now here, what are the important processes? Number one, it is weathering. Number two, it is erosion. Number three, transportation. Number four, it is mass wasting. So these are the general processes which act behind this denudation process. Now, what is weathering? You all know. Weathering means obviously wearing down of rocks, but the rocks particles will not be transported both from a particular place to another place. Removal will not take place in weathering. But in erosion, when the rock is degrading away or when a rock is getting degraded, after a certain time, with the help of so many agents like wind, water or glacier, the particles will be removed from a particular place and then it will be transported to another place. That is known as erosion. In erosion, definitely removal will take place. Number three, that is transportation. Now, what is transportation? Obviously, transportation means from a particular place, the rock material, they are transporting by the agents of like exogenic processes like wind, rivers, glaciers and so on. So erosion and transportation, both of these are quite similar, but still in your book, they are written separately. Then there is mass wasting. What is mass wasting? Now just imagine like the hill region or mountainous region. There the particles, they are very loosely packed, okay, to the surface of the region. Then what will happen? We know that there is always a gravitational attraction by the earth. So due to the gravitational attraction, the particles, they generally sliding down from the surface of the earth, sorry, from the surface of the hilly region to the plain region. That is known as mass wasting. Though this mass wasting is very slow process, it takes lot of time. Okay, so these are the basic processes that act behind this denudation. Now, in denudation, we will learn about so many agents. What are the agents? Like previously I told you, that is river, wind and glacier. Okay, about these three agents and what are their work, how they do the erosional work, how they do the depositional work, we all will study this one by one. So in this class, I'm just going to give you some important terminology about river and what are the erosional work of the river and what are the important landforms that generally developed by the erosional work of river. So before starting this, we need to know what do you mean by soil profile, what do you mean by river profile. Now river profile, if I draw a river, then you can see that river, it is generally originated from a mountainous part. from a glacier that is located at the top of the mountain. So the point from where the river is originated, it is known as source of river. Okay, now after getting originated, it generally flowed down because it is also following the slope, the mountainous slope. And when they will flow down and then they will mix with the, or they will meet to this ocean surface or any lakes or any other water body, that meeting point will be known as the mouth of river. So first the originating point is known as source, and the meeting point of the river to any other water body like oceans, seas, lakes, they are known as mouth. This is known as mouth of the river. Done. Now in this whole river profile, profile means from the originating point to the meeting point, this whole thing is known as the river profile. Now this river profile is divided into three parts. One is upper course, second is middle course, and last one is lower course. Now upper course means when the river, it is flowing through the mountainous region. Okay, that time the river will have more energy and the power of erosion will be also more. So this phrase is known as upper course of the river. Now when the river, it is coming down and it is flowing through the plateau region or any region that is in less slope than mountainous zone, that is known as middle course. And keep in your mind that in middle course, the power of transportation of the river will be higher than the erosion. Okay. And at the last moment, when the river will just reach the plain region, then obviously the erosional as well as the transportation facilities or transportation power of the river will be completely low. And then only one thing river will do, it will start depositing of the materials. Okay. And this course is known as lower course. So this is all about the river profile. The river which is having these three type of courses are known as idle river. And in India, Ganga is the major example of idle river. Done. Now I think the major terminology of the river, it is quite clear. Here one thing I need to mention, that is, what do you mean by the river course or river valley? It is nothing but the area through which the river flows, that is known as the river valley. Okay, so I think this one is quite clear. Now I am going to move towards the form of, or towards the function of rivers, which are they? Number one, erosional work. Number two, transportational work. And number three, depositional work. Now in this class, I am just going to discuss about the erosional work of river, or what are the basic function of the river in the upper course. Both the questions are same. Okay. So here, when the river is flowing in the mountainous part or in the upper course, then this river will have large amount of velocity. What is the meaning of velocity? The speed of the river will be high. Why so? Because here the river is flowing through the slope, and when the slope is very steep, that means generally in the upper course, the slope of the river remains very steep. So that means obviously the speed of the river will also increase. Okay. And at this time, the river will flow with a very high speed. And another important factor that is present here, the slope of the landform has to be very high. Okay. So these two are the basic important factors that is needed for the erosional work of the river. Number one, huge amount of water should be present. Now, and the speed of the river should be very high. And number two is the steep of the slope should be very high. Done. Now, what are the major landforms that generally created or developed through the erosional work of a river? Erosion means here the river is eroding away the material from the landform. If the river, it is flowing through this slope, then what it will do? It will erode away the materials from the slope of the mountain. okay, and afterwards the materials it will be deposited by the river only. So first in the upper course the river will do only the erosional work. So there are so many landforms, so many structure on the earth surface has been created or has been developed by the river. What are they? Let's look into this. Okay, so here number one is I-shaped valley and V-shaped valley. So what is this? Number one, I and V-shaped valleys. Now by this we can understand that I and V, these are the English letters. Okay, so here the valley shape will be either I or V. Now when a river is flowing through a particular landform or through its course, then what will happen if the erosional work of the river is applicable in the downward side, then it will form I-shaped valley. When the river is eroding the landform in the downward side, then it will be known as I-shaped, because then it will create this I-shaped valley. And when the river will erode the valley sideward, okay, not in a vertical way, in horizontal way, then it will be known as V-shaped valley. Okay, now in Colorado River, Grand Canyon, it is the most interesting example of I-shaped valley. So first point I told you, that was I-shaped and V-shaped. What is I-shaped? When the river will erode the valley in a vertical way, then it is known as I, and when it is eroding the valley in a horizontal manner, then it will be known as V-shaped valley. Now number two point, it is waterfalls. Now what is waterfall? If the is the waterfall. Now what is waterfall? If the hard rock and soft rock, it is sequentially placed, then what will happen? River, it will not be able to erode the hard rock, but it can easily erode the soft rock over here. So like this, after few years we can see that there will be complete erosion of soft rock, but hard rock will remain same. Then when the river is flowing, it can easily fall like this, because it is not getting any support from the soft rock. Okay, so this type of landforms will create the waterfall, and when the water is falling here in the foot area, it will create a hole that is known as plunge pool. Okay, so this is all about the waterfall. In India there are so many waterfalls present. Like in southern India we can find the waterfall more, because the South India is generally created by hard rocks and there the speed of the river is very high. Okay, now next is pothole. Okay, what is pothole? When the river is flowing through this river, we know that during this erosional process river is eroding the materials, like so some sand, silt, clay, these materials will be carried out by the river. So when the river is carrying all the materials with it, and when the river is flowing through a valley, then what will happen? When this material will be collapse or will do the collision with this surface or with the base of the river bed, then it will create a hole, certain hole in the river bed. That is known as pothole. Again, I am describing this. When the river is flowing, it is carrying some important materials with it. Okay, and while moving, the materials will be do some addition, or it will be engaged in collision with the river bed, and then it will create a hole in the river bed, and that hole is known as pothole. Okay, so I hope that this is quite clear, and this is all about the important landforms that is developed by the erosional work of river. After this session I'm going to put some important questions. Please note it down, and in our next class we are going to discuss about the middle course and the lower course of the river profile. Till then, thank you and take care.